Mr. Speaker and honorable members, this is the brief on the celebration of the second World Kiswahili Language Day in the ESC. It is intended to promote the use of Kiswahili as an official language in Uganda and create awareness about the East African community. You may be aware that Article 62 of our Constitution stipulates that Kiswahili is the second official language, but we have never actually actualized it. Article 137 of the Treaty for the ESC states that Kiswahili should be the lingua franca of the East African community. The Yala Assembly passed many resolutions urging the summit to consider amending the treaty to make this an official language. And on 27th February 2021, the summit declared both Swahili and English.
Switch on the microphone, right?
Now, on 5th November 2021, UNESCO declared 7th July as the World Swahili Day and should be celebrated throughout the world by all the stakeholders. It has been supported by all the councils in the ESC, and in Swahili, it's not Siku ya Kiswahili Duniani. Now, last year, the celebrations were in Zanzibar. The president of Zanzibar officiated and gave a platform for us to reflect on the role of Kiswahili in the ESC region. And at that time, Uganda was given an opportunity to host this year. Therefore, the meeting will take place here in Kampala on the 6th and the 7th of July, 2023. It will bring together stakeholders, researchers, policymakers, practitioners, teachers, students, ordinary citizens. There will also be recognition awards for those who have been working very hard on the issue of Kiswahili. So the benefits are many. It will bring together all the stakeholders, provide a platform, celebrate and reflect on the role of Kiswahili in the ESC, to sensitize stakeholders on the growing role, importance and opportunities of Kiswahili at the national, regional, global scene, publicize and popularize Kiswahili as an official language of the ESC, harness the potential of various stakeholders to support Kiswahili activities. We are quite prepared. We have a regional organizing committee. We are going to have media briefings, radio talk shows, youth dialogue on Twitter spaces, etc. The theme for this year is Kiswahili and multilingualism, achieving more together. We shall have goodwill messages from the leaders of all the heads of states and different delegations from all the partner states. And there will be, Mr. Speaker, the presentation will be in Kiswahili and will be translated to English and French. So this is an opportunity now for us to listen to those presentations. We have decided that each country represents something. Therefore, the Republic of Uganda would present on living my life in Kiswahili and other languages. The East African Swahili Commission will present on regional integration, emerging multilingualism. Republic of Kenya will present on Kiswahili, multilingualism, and Pan-Africanism. Republic of Rwanda will present on benefits and challenges of multilingualism, theory and practice. The United Republic of Tanzania will present Kiswahili language policy and planning in a multilingual setting. Republic of Kenya will have a second chance, Kiswahili translation interpretation. Republic of South Sudan present on conflict, Kiswahili and multilingualism. United Republic of Tanzania, of course it has Zanzibar. They will also present Kiswahili, creative and creation and economy, music in multiple languages. Uganda will have a chance on Kiswahili language education. The Republic of Burundi on development of Kiswahili and other languages. So now members, I'm inviting you to come to Hotel Africana on the 6th and the 7th of July, attend the symposium, see what is happening so that we can all work together to promote integration in the East African community. Thank you very much.